Hey everyone, welcome back. This is the part 2 of the WebSockets introduction. So in this video, I'm going to talk about the WebSockets, a very basic implementation in just two files. So I'll try to explain as good as I can, so stick to the end. And if you have any questions, then don't forget to leave them in the comment section. And yeah, without wasting your time, let's go ahead and take a look what I prepared for this one. So here you can see I have two files. The first one is the HTML file, and the second one is the JavaScript file, right? So inside the HTML file, I have basically have four input. I have the form input, which allows a user to send a message, and I have also an UL element, which will output all the messages from the server. Here I have inside the script tag, I'm initializing a socket. Here you can see that I'm passing an event listener for the window object. So whenever the page loads, I'm passing the event listener for onload. So whenever the page loads, this function will be executed. And so what we'll get is that here I'm creating the WebSocket by accessing the WebSocket API, right? So I'm accessing this one. I'm passing the URL as an argument in which I spoke in my last video. So if you missed the first part, then I will strongly suggest you to watch the first part as well. So you can see that I have basically four event listeners for our socket that I'm creating here. So the four event listeners here. The first one is an unopened event listener, which will listen to the opening connection. So whenever the connection is open between the server and the client, then this function will be fired. And so I'm constantly logging the date to local string, and then I'm passing the string new connection established. The second event listener will listen for an on error event. So basically, whenever there was an error, I will console error the message in the console. The third one is the on message event, which will be fired whenever we get a message from the server. And so when we get the message, I'm console logging this message with the date and the string new message received and an event dot data, because we can pass an event as an argument, and then we can access this argument inside the function. And whenever that's happened, I'm basically appending this message by calling append message function, which I created here. So here is my append message, which basically takes the message as an argument. Here I'm accessing the data on this message. And here I'm creating an li element. Here I'm passing this data as an inner text to this element, and I'm appending this this element to our chat element, which I'm accessing here or here, right? And so here again I have also my form input, so where I'm adding an event listener for submit event. And so whenever the user submit a message, then I'm preventing the default behavior of the form. I'm accessing the data from this messages from this message. I'm sending this message by accessing our socket the same way I'm using the socket for our event listeners. So here I'm accessing the socket, and I'm passing the send method, which will send the message to our server, right? And on this line, I'm basically resetting the input. So whenever the user sends the message, the input will be empty, right? So this is a very simple HTML file for the WebSocket. And so let's take a look at the JS file, our server. So the first step, you want to take is the you want to initialize the package .json, and you can do it by writing the npm init minus epsilon, and what it does, it will create a package .json with all the options specified as default, so you don't have to click in on yes every time. So the second step will be to install the Express and WS packages from the npm. And the first step, the first step will be basically to run our node server.js command in the terminal after you have all the code inside this file. But let me explain you all the code that I have here in this file. So on this line, I'm basically accessing our WS package. So I'm creating a WebSocket value of variable. Here I'm accessing the HTTP from the Node.js. Here I'm accessing the Express. And on this line, I'm creating an HTTP server where I'm passing our Express value or the variable, which will create a server for us. And you can see that it's on this line, I'm listening on the port 8080. And so whenever this the server opens and is listening on this URL, on this port, then I'm getting a console server is listening on port 8080. And so here you can see that I'm also creating a WebSocket server by accessing our WebSocket package and the server method, and I'm passing in our server, our HTTP server, as an argument. And so this line will create basically a new WebSocket server for us, which we can use to send a message to all the clients or all the users that are subscribed to the same domain, right? So here you can see that I'm passing an event listener on our WebSocket server. And the event listener is a connection. So whenever there was a connection on the server and the client side, I'm passing a console log with the date and the string connection established. And on our WebSocket server, we can also pass a callback with an argument. And the argument will be the WebSocket that was created on the WebSocket server. And so here you can see that I'm taking this socket and I'm passing event listener message. So whenever there was a message, I'm taking this message that was passed in from the client, and I'm looping through all the clients from our WebSocket server, and I'm sending this message. So I'm on this line, I'm checking at the first step is that to check if the client is in the WebSocket server, and the second one, if the ready state is open. So this this checks if the WebSocket on the client side isn't closed. So whenever this is open, then I'm sending the message. So here I'm accessing the client and the send method and passing the message as an argument. Right, so this was the application and the code base. And so let's take a look at the browser exactly. So here you can see I have two windows, two browsers. So the first one, if I refresh the page, yeah, I get the time and the date whenever the connection was established. And when I go to the second one and I refresh the page, you can see that the time is different, right? So this means that we have basically now two users connected to the same server. And so when I wrote a message, for example, I say hello, right? I get the message at the second one. So that means that our two users are connected to the same server, and I can just send the message from the one to the second one, or from the one client to the server, and all the other clients that are connected to the same server will receive the messages. So here you can see them. Say WhatsApp, right? So as you can see, our application works. It is working. Amazing. All right, so that's it. As I said, it was a really basic implementation, but I hope you enjoyed this one. If you have any questions, then leave them in the comment section. And all right, I will see you next time. Bye.